Is it really necessary to brew Coors Light down as low as 34 degrees? Do the mountains really need to turn blue when your beer's as cold as the Rockies? You be the judge. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
Well, our final chalk talk for the Seahawks. We'll see if something emerges in the NFL playoffs or Super Bowl that we can highlight on the old chalkboard here, X's and O's style. But the final one is a fitting one, and it's once again pointed to, and how many times did it this year, the Seahawks run game that was so good at creating a 1,000-yard rusher in Marshawn Lynch, creating the production that we've all been wanting to see out of that run game. And this wasn't Marshawn this time. This was the Leon Washington, the long touchdown run he had. But I hope what stands out to you as we've done these Chalk Talks all year, and in particular about the Seahawks run game, is first and foremost, I think something that Tom Cable did this year and got these guys to believe in, maybe that better than they ever have in the past, and that is getting a helmet on a helmet, that all 11 of them, and it takes that offensively, it takes a quarterback who's willing and able at the line of scrimmage to check to the right plays, and T-Jack did that on occasion, and then it's the whole group, it's your receivers buying in, it's your tight ends blocking, something that the Seahawks have really struggled to do for many years without Zach Miller being that force this season. So the commitment in the run game to get a helmet on a helmet, and then leaving those unblocked defenders to make the tackles, and making sure you get the right people on the other side unblocked, because you can't account for them all. You got a quarterback, it's already 10 versus 11. Many times in the run game, they can outnumber you, so you're not going to get them all. But offensively, and Tom Cable did a wonderful job this year of saying, okay, we can't get everybody. Who do we want to leave unblocked? And then it's up to you, Leon. It's up to you, Marshawn, to make that play. I want to go back first and foremost to the San Francisco game a week ago. We were on holiday and I didn't get to draw it up. But you heard Pete Carroll say to us in our conversation we have with him that in that 49er game, they wanted to get a body on the front, on those front four guys. And they were going to leave some of those linebackers free for Michael Robinson to block and for Marshawn to run over. It was a little bit different this week when you looked at Arizona. They said, no, we're going to get a helmet on this front, and we're going to make Patrick Peterson, and we're going to make their free safety, we're going to make their other corner beat us. Those guys are going to be the ones for Leon and Marshawn to get after. When you see this scheme, and once again, this is a very similar scheme to one we saw all year long. All this was a zone run play that Leon ultimately cuts all the way back. And when you look at the leverage, and you looked at the group coming down, and some of the leverage they got, and a helmet on a helmet, everything was once again pretty favorable for you, and your tight ends played a big role. Zach Miller does his job washing out the linebacker. We see our McCoy come across and take out the linebacker. So immediately you see the crease, and as you see this thing just playing out numbers-wise, well, and you see even your big tackle, Jean-Pierre, come across and try to get his head and get just enough of a body, you see what exactly I'm pointing to. A helmet on a helmet. Numbers here. Creating that crease in that cutback lane, and then it's on Leon Washington. And so not only do you get a helmet on the important guys, secondly, you had this year, maybe more than any other year, your running back's ability to beat the unblocked guy. And that's what really stands out in Leon's run here. You get the leverage, you get the appropriate numbers, you get McCoy to get the kick out block, you create that seam, and then this was awesome. When you watch this on replay and you hear all the time about these running backs in this zone system being able to plant their foot and get downhill, watch this run by Leon. There's a reason that Marshawn came over to him and gave him some love on the bench. His ability to feel that crease. And you could see both Marshawn and Leon this year. Look and study this. Remember the conversations we had this year and Tom Cable talking to Marshawn Lynch? This is what it's about, man. When you get at the line of scrimmage, you as a running back, tune into the front. Look at the shades. Look at the leverage. It can give you an indicator of where that crease is going to be on the backside. And when you see a Gallery and a McQuiston come down and wash that out and all the flow, and you see the backside cutoff that we saw how many times this year from McCoy and from Zach Miller, there's a crease. And then, Leon, you get paid to make that guy miss. And then lastly, I want to point out, maybe for more fun than anything else, watch our rookie Lockett here. He goes in and he tries to block the safety, but he's so far in the box he can't get him. And you're going to see a guy run a 4.3 40 right into our friend Max Unger. And I guarantee you Max Unger looked at him and goes, dude, what are you doing? Yet at the same time, there was such a conviction. And that's the last thing for 2011. Whether it's Lockett flying in, whether it's McCoy blocking, whether it's this group getting a helmet on a helmet, the conviction the Seahawks had to their run game, an enormous reason why they had the production they did this season.